What's up everybody and welcome to another YouTube video, and in this YouTube video we're going to be talking about how I'm able to avoid paying that premium of living right next to the ocean, and how on the contrary I'm actually able to make a profit of $1,831 per month. And if you guys stick all the way to the end of the video, I will actually be giving a night tour as well. So sit back and relax and enjoy the video.
Starting off, we have the kind of entryway here where we have a wooden floor where you could put your shoes there so you don't dirty up the carpet whenever you come in. You have two doors here, mostly for storage, but we're not going to go in there because it's kind of messy. And being in the studio, we have to find a lot of creative ways to make as much room as possible. So those doors are pretty much loaded with stuff. And then panning over here to the main living room, this is pretty much it, you guys. Welcome to my entire studio. You pretty much have the living room, the dining room, the kitchen, everything that you want in a house in about 400 square feet of space. Literally one step to our left over to the living room, we have this IKEA $75 bed with a $140 Wayfair full mattress. We kind of wanted to go with black, as you will notice with most of the furniture here, because we did not want to go too above and beyond with the decorations, because the more above and beyond that you go, the more expensive it can typically be. This lamp was already free because it was already my girlfriend's, so thankfully we didn't have to pay for a new light source. Over here is a table that we got from IKEA, at least just a slab. One thing I noticed when I was looking for tables was that they are just super expensive. So what we did was we got this $20 slab at IKEA in the discount section and bought like $5 stilts. And so added up, it came a lot less to like $100. So we definitely saved a lot of money there. We kind of use it for cooking as well, because as you will tell later, we have very limited kitchen space. So we'll do a lot of our cooking here, put a lot of decorations here. This lamp right here was a gift for my 21st birthday from my mother. Being from LA, I do kind of like the whole movie scene of Hollywood. So this kind of brings like a nice ambient light during the day and night. And I just think it looks really cool. And then also right here at the bottom of this light, I will have this kind of little thing here where I keep my keys and little kind of lighters here for our candles. You'll notice we have a bunch of candles later. LEDs up here, that is really nice for ambient lighting, not just during the day, but also at night. We have a mirror also that was already my girlfriend's, so we didn't have to pay for that. We have a $10 coffee table here from IKEA, nothing too much special. We do have my work computer there that I'll edit all my YouTube videos on. It's a movie projector, which is pretty cool because over in that back wall, it turns into an entire large TV screen. Which is pretty sweet. And then we have this curtain that cost about like $30. Not really a curtain, mostly fabric that we kind of got. Like I said before, being from like LA and Hollywood, I really wanted like a kind of movie theater sort of setup with this $8 lighting from Amazon that is dimmable. So it creates a really nice mood at night to sort of just sit down on this futon to watch movies. This futon costs us about $40. We were looking at futons to buy and they were really expensive. So what we did was we just got this used one for like $40 and painted it with about $2 worth of black paint. Bought like a $5 bed sheet from Walmart. And then, like I said, painted this whole thing black. The mattress is extremely dirty, but we clean it like 3 times, and we could probably resell this thing for probably like at least $120 now. Here we have a plant. I think adding a lot of greenery to someone's place kind of really opens it up more and brings this really nice kind of vibe to the entire area. Then looking over to the right, we just have our normal kitchen. Nothing too much going on here. Extremely small kitchen. That's why we kind of do most of our cooking on the table over there. We have a couple of holiday sort of little mittens there, because we've been using a rag once too many times to take that cast iron pan out of the oven, and we have burned ourselves more times than we can count. We did have to spend a little bit of money there in buying those things, which cost like $3. Right in front of the futon, we have this table that I actually made myself. The table was almost free. The palette was free. All we did was paint it with about $3 worth of acrylic paint. We have a $10 lantern on there, and then the little stands were about $4 each from Walmart, which we could put like candles or even like those little mini pumpkins there for like decorations. And then right below it is like a $20 rug that we got from Amazon to kind of tie the whole room together with that black theme. Looking over to our right, we have this cat tree, $75. Momo loves it. I don't know if you already saw my cat. I probably passed right by him, but that is Momo. He's a little baby. He acts like a baby. And like early in the morning and late at night, we will just get randomly woken up by him using the crap out of this thing. So we know he loves it. Coming into the bathroom here, to our right, we have like a litter box and some of the storage stuff, which is again kind of crowded, so we're not gonna look at that. But this is your pretty much standard bathroom. Not too much to talk about it. We do have a candle there sort of for a little bit of ambiance as well. And then I don't know if you can see, but we even have like kind of like a flickering firelight. Now that really complements this tree shower curtain, because with the shower curtain and the light outside, it kind of makes you feel like you're in some sort of like magical forest and a unicorn's gonna pop out the shower head or something. I don't know, that's how I feel. But yeah, that's pretty much the entire bathroom. Now in the future, I do want to get a one bed, one bath apartment. So that way in the one bed, we won't actually put the bed there, but I wanted to create a YouTube studio, kind of just do all my work there and my real estate research there, because I feel kind of like, while you're spending the extra money, I feel like I'm actually going to use the space, and it's just going to give me motivation to actually do work. So I'm kind of looking forward to upgrading here in a little bit. And in the video that I'm about to show you guys, I will actually talk more about not upgrading, but I think in terms of upgrading for the sake of doing more work, and if it's going to make me more productive, then I feel like it's a pretty sound investment. After the main video, I will actually show you guys a night tour, because at night this thing just looks incredible. Now, with half showing you guys my place, it's time to talk about everybody's favorite part, and that is what it cost me to live here and how much do I actually make by living here. Being in the military and living out in town entitles me to two different types of pay, and those types of pay are BAH and BAS. BAH, or basic allowance for housing, is the money the military will give you to live out in town, and the money will vary greatly on where you are located in the world. For example, the BAH rate in San Francisco without dependents is going to be $3,285. And in Virginia Beach, where I'm currently stationed, you're going to be earning about $1,224 in BAH. Also without dependents. Now, I will be living in this apartment up until August of next year, and I won't stop receiving BAH until October 16th of 2021, which means I can expect to earn about 14 months worth of BAH. Now, I will be living here for the next 12 months, and the other 2 months from the 14 months comes from here. You see, I should be receiving back pay my BAH back in September, even though I moved out in August, and I wasn't receiving any BAH for the month of September. But like I said, I'll be getting that back. And the other month is October, because even though I'll be moving out by August, I can still receive BAH for the month of September and October, even if I take terminal leave, which is me leaving a month early paid vacation thanks to the military. Of course, you do have to save up for that. Just keep that in mind. So by doing some simple math, for those 14 months, I'll be receiving about $17,136. Now it's time to bring our attention to the BAS. BAS is going to be the amount of money that the military gives you in order to eat out in town when you live out in town. Obviously, the military realizes it's going to be a struggle, and it's not practical to keep coming onto base and eating at the galley if you live outside of base. And for this, the military will pay you $372 to eat outside. Of that, I spend about $130 a month. I just started receiving BAS actually for this month of October. However, with BAS, I won't be receiving back pay for the previous month. So this means for the next 12 months, I'll be receiving $4,472. Adding both my BAH and BAS together, I would be earning $21,983. Divide that by 12 and you get $1,831 per month to live right next to the beach. And the great thing that I almost forgot to mention is that all of this money is tax-free.
It's free real estate.
Of course, this is all gross income, and net income is going to be slightly different. You see, I do have to pay rent, and in the month of August, I paid $377 for that month's rent, then $1,078 until July of next year, and then $688 for the month of August, seeing that I'm not going to be living there for the full month. Add all that up, and coming out of pocket is $12,923 getting stolen by rent. But I also share this place with my roommate, who happens to be my girlfriend, who is also receiving BAH. So split this in half, and now I'm paying $6,461 to live next to the beach. Subtract that from my gross profit of BAH and BAS, and that nets me $15,519, or about $1,293 per month. Now, getting BAH is going to greatly depend on your command. You see, some commands are a lot stingier than others, and some are going to be more than glad to get you BAH as soon as possible. From my experience, those who live on the ship and are below E4, yeah, you can forget about getting BAH. But if you are a petty officer and you're in a squadron, more than likely, you'll probably have a better chance of receiving it versus the former. Now, if you live in the barracks and have achieved a rank of petty officer, you can apply for getting your BAH. However, varying upon command, there will have to be about a 95% to 100% occupancy rate in your barracks on your base. Now, like I said before, if you're on the ship, you probably won't get it because there's already beds for you there, and for some reason the Navy thinks that by giving you a 4x7-foot rack, that's plenty of room for you to live the next couple years of your life. And now, while that is kind of possible, it does suck. To be honest, either if you're on a ship or a squadron, about 99% of the time, you won't be receiving BAH until at least you've been in for about 2 years.
This gives you time to kind of look good on paper for your chain of command once you write up the paperwork through, and hopefully would have given you enough time to achieve the rank of petty officer, because you'll just look that much better when your paperwork goes up to your CO and he'll be able to approve it. So one of the best ways to get BAH as fast as possible is to honestly just look really good on paper as much as possible. This means getting your air pin and your service pin as fast as possible, studying and earning as many quals as you can in your rate as fast as you can, and trying to achieve the rank as petty officer as quick as you can. I'll make a video later explaining about some of the rates that rank up extremely fast so you can sort of cheat the system. But for this video, just assume that you're gonna be waiting at least 2 to 3 years until you start receiving BAH. Now, once you have it, I cannot emphasize this enough, that is not extra spending money. I know a lot of sailors like to joke around and talk about getting married so they can have more money so that they can spend on cars or whatever else floats their boat. Or should I say, floats their Navy ship.
Oh, brother, this guy stinks!
So once you have everything done and you know your paperwork's gonna get approved and you're more than likely gonna get BAH, you are definitely going to want to find a place where you can live that's a lot lower than the BAH rate in the area. For example, if you do get stationed in Virginia and you are receiving $1,224 a month, you're gonna wanna find something way lower than that. Now, if you want a little bit of a BAH secret, you could actually live with some friends if they're offering a room for sale. And if you're in good with your friend who charges you really little, you could be pocketing anywhere from about 60 to 100% depending on how good the friend is. However, if that is not an option, then you can just look into your regular renting an apartment or house. Now again, if you are renting from an apartment, you're gonna wanna find the cheapest place possible. This way you can maximize the amount of BAH that you can get, because whatever you don't spend, you get to keep. Same for the BAS, keep that in mind. Then step two, which could really be step one, is choosing if you wanna either rent a house or purchase a house. In my opinion, if you're gonna be staying in the military for over 20 years and wanna make this a career, I would actually suggest buying a house because the Navy will pretty much pay the mortgage for you. I know a lot of higher ups in my chain of command that have done this, where every duty station they've been to, they purchased the property. And that's no matter where they go. So if they get stationed in San Diego, boom, they buy a house. If they get stationed in Virginia Beach, boom, they buy a house. All with using the VA home loan. However, if you're going to be staying in the Navy short term and you know that you're not going to be staying there after your service and you want to go back home to wherever home is, then renting might just be the better option. That way, there's no pressure to actually stay behind and you get to follow your dreams on whatever you want to do once you get out. Now, step three is going to be with living with other people. For example, I live with my girlfriend, and honestly, if it wasn't for her, I would be spending double the amount that I would be currently spending now. There's no limit on how many people can receive BAH and live in the same place at once. This means if you and five of your buddies all decide to get a house and all split your BAH, that is about a $6,000 a month income living almost wherever you want to live in Virginia Beach. So the more people, definitely the merrier. Just make sure they're not the kind of people that'll screw you over on paying you every month, because you do get some of those people in the military, as well as real life. So choose your friends wisely. Now, step number four, which is honestly the pretty fun one that I like to advise, is going to be buying used or making your own furniture. I didn't realize that when I first bought my studio apartment, how expensive furniture was. You see, I thought maybe I can just get a cheap bed that'll cost me like $30, brand new from IKEA or something, a mattress that'll cost me like $80 on Wayfair, and then call that a day. Yeah, that was not the case. Now, if you're not gonna be living in the property for very long, there's absolutely no sense into buying new furniture from anywhere. And if you are going to buy new furniture from anywhere, make sure it's one of the cheapest, most least expensive things, however sturdy, that you could buy. For example, my IKEA Needham bed only cost me about $75 for the frame and about $140 for the full mattress, and honestly, it works like any other bed would. It's not like the bed transforms, Tempur-Pedic, mattress, bed, fancy schmancy stuff. And to be honest, I probably would have been fine just sleeping in a sleeping bag. However, my girlfriend was not up for that idea. Another example is the futon. Me and my girlfriend were shopping around for seating stuff so that when guests came over, they could have some place to kind of sit and chat. And if any family came over or friends came to visit and they wanted to spend the night, it could fold into a bed so that they can sleep there. But after looking online, we realized that futons are a lot more expensive than we thought. We were able to find that futon used on Rakai for about $40, and about $10 painting, fixing it up, and just getting a regular black bed sheet to put over it, and boom. Now honestly, seeing what else was on the market, we could easily resell this for about $130. So boom, just like that, by making our own furniture and refurbishing it, we earned about $70, and instead of losing money, we gained some money. And if you're not the crafty person that can make your own furniture, just get a wooden pallet. That black painted wooden pallet that I showed you guys earlier, all it really needed was some black paint and some stuff to put underneath it and some sandpaper, and that was it. So definitely try to be creative in the ways that you acquire your furniture, because if you're not paying attention, they could really eat into your wallet. And honestly, I could probably sell that table for at least $40, seeing what tables were going for on the market when we were looking to buy one. Now, probably the most important and last step after receiving your BAH is going to be do not inflate your living style. This one's important because before BAH, you're probably living in the barracks or on the ship. And if you know what that's like, you probably did not like it. So now that you got your own place out in town, you got your own car probably, and you're eating out and you're getting groceries and you have all this freedom, well then now you're probably thinking, oh, you know, maybe I should get that $150, you know, desk from IKEA because I'm getting BAH to pay for that anyways. Or hey, you know, maybe I'm gonna go down to this restaurant over here because it's like 5 minutes down from where I live and it's fine because I'm getting BAH to pay for that anyways. Or this one right here, oh, you know, I'll just go ahead and pay like $1,300 a month even though I'm only receiving $1,224 because I'm really only paying about $20 out of pocket to live somewhere a lot better. Listen, I want you to be aware that you're already upgrading a ton from living in a little rack to finally getting your own place out in town. Now, even though you're already getting paid for it, that should honestly already satisfy any of your inflation sort of tendencies you have in your mind. So no matter what, still try to live below your means and try to pay at least 50% under at whatever your BAH rate is and wherever you're stationed. Instead, take that money that you would have ordinarily has spent and then use all that money that you saved up to then go reinvest back into the markets to grow that money. Now, all this BAH and BAS money is really gonna hit you like a truck. So when you finally receive it, you need to do your very best not to let it get to your head and just be thankful you were able to get out of the base to begin with. And with all that being said, thank you guys for watching this video. Sync that like button to Davy Jones's locker and do not forget to subscribe for more content. But honestly, if you took the time to finish and watch all the way to the end, I really just want to give you a big thank you because I mean, it really means a lot to me that you found that much interest in my videos to keep watching. And it's people like you giving me the motivation why I even want to keep doing these videos in the first place. Thank you guys so much for watching and I will see you guys next time.